See here this problem. Here how to find the voltage drops across each capacitor. So without finding the effective capacitance and charge, we can easily find the voltage drops by using a voltage divider formula. So let's see here what is that formula. This is the formula we are going to use for finding the voltage drops across each capacitor. So whenever the capacitors are in series, we can use these formulas for finding the voltages. So let's see here. This is C1 capacitor and this is C2 capacitor. Now I want the V1, that means V1. So V1 equal to, take the opposite capacitance, that is C2. So here C2 is 4 Faraday divided by C1 plus C2, means sum of these two capacitors, 6 plus 4, 10 into source voltage. Source voltage is 20 volts. 10 ones, 10 twos, 4 twos are 8. So V1 equal to 8 volts. And this is the voltage drop across C1 capacitor. Similarly, you can find the V2. So V2 equal to, take the opposite capacitance, that is C1, 6 Faraday into total voltage source, that is 20, divided by sum of the capacitors, that is 6 Faraday plus 4 Faraday. So it becomes 6 into 20 by 10, 10 ones, 10 twos. That's equal to 12 volts. So V2 equal to 12 volts. So this is the voltage drops across each capacitor. And this is the process of voltage divided formula. And these are the two important formula for finding the voltage drops. And thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share. Thanks.